सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिनि व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ रक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। ॐ यो ब्रह्माण विदाति गुरु येदाश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुं देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्यं। शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आमनायन्ते संसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। सूत्र इन दी थर्ड पाद ऑफ दी सेकंड अध्याय। सो वी आर लुकिंग एट दी रिफ्यूटेशन ऑफ दी पूर्व पक्ष अक्रॉस एज मेनी सूत्रास। द 20th सूत्र वॉज पृथगोपदेशात बिकॉज देर इज अ टीचिंग ऑफ डिफरेंस बिटवीन दी कर्ता एंड करण। Thereby, this jnana, which you are saying is the reason, the guna, which becomes the reason for the anubhava of the anything across the sharira, although the atma is localized as anu in the hridaya desha. That is not right because the Kartru and Karana are said to be different, said the Purvapakshi, and therefore you, the Siddhanti, claiming that this Guna Guni are not seen as separate. That was the Akshepa. So earlier, if you look at it, Aduna Jnanena Eva Atmana Deha Vyaptirityatra Shrutimaha. No, before that. ननु गुण गुणी व्यतिरेकेण गुणस्य वृत्तेः अन्यत्र अदर्शनात् तत्कथम् इत्याशंक्याः। जस्ट गिव मी मोमेंट। एम आई राइट? 20th सूत्र वाज ओवर, राइट? यू आर येट टू सी द सिद्धांत। एम आई राइट? आई एम अ लिटिल कंफ्यूज्ड टुडे एज टू व्हाट वाज द लास्ट पार्ट। इज दैट राइट सतीश जी? आई थिंक माय वॉल्यूम इज लो, आई डोंट हियर, सॉरी।
Hello, do you hear me?
Yeah, now I'm able to hear. So we have finished 28th sutra, right?
Yeah, Prithagopadeshat was completed.
Yeah, it was completed, right? We are yet to see Siddhanta, right? Siddhantastu.
Yep.
Okay, okay. So yeah, so I jumped the gun. So I was thinking that some sutras here are over. Yeah, I remember that. This is not covered, right? So, okay. So, the Prithagopadeshat, up to Prithagopadeshat, it has many sutras. What has been seen is the Purvapakshi Sutra. All our Purvapakshi Sutras. And what he is expressing towards the end is that a response to this. So, nanu guni vyatirekena gunasya vrittihe anyatra adarshana tatkatam ityashanke aha. We have never seen guna and guni separate from each other. Was the akshepa to the Purvapakshi, who is claiming that this jnana makes the anubhava possible, although Atma is Anu and in Hridaya Akasha. So Anubhava of the entire Sharira and through the Jnana, all this is possible. So Guna Guni, meaning Jnana as a Guna and Guni Jnani Atma, they are not seen separately, if that is a claim by the Siddhanti or some other, some other Darshanika to the Purvapakshi, then Purvapakshi is saying it is not true. Because we have seen there is a Prithak Upadesha also. Hetvantara is there that Jnanena Eva Atmana Deha Vyapti. So the Jnana is different, Atma is different, and there is separation also possible. Therefore, Jnana can be all around and then bring in the Vishaya of the Jnana to the Atma also. Thereby, you can have Anubhava of the Shaitya with an example that was given as to a person who is immersed in Ganga. If that person as Jivatma is in Hridaya Akasha, then he cannot have Shaitya Anubhava all over the body. But it is possible through Jnana, which is separated, like gandha is separated, gandha particles are separated. So similar can be the case in the exemplified atma having jnana or anubhava of the shaitya which is across the sharira, throughout the sharira. Siddhanta, so Siddhanta is refuting this through sutras now. So the first sutra there is tadgunasaratvattu tadvyapadesha prajnyavat, tadgunasaratvattu tadvyapadesha prajnyavat. So here prajna has the meaning prajnyavat, like prajna. Prajna here means Ishvara. So what is the Siddhanti saying? Tadguna saratvat tu tadvyapadeshaha. Tadvyapadesha is a samasa, the teaching of that. How? Like prajna. Like the teaching of prajna, where in the upasana kanda, upasana sections, what do you have? There is a teaching of the Parameshwara also in Hridayakasha. Parameshwara is said to be in Hridayakasha. Jiva is said also said to be in the Hriddesha. So what is the problem there? Ask the Siddhanti, how can you take it to be literal in the sense the Paramatma we have explained in the first chapter as being in the Hridayakasha does not make the Paramatma limited. Paramatma does not become Anu. Paramatma remains, this Brahma Tattva remains Vyapaka Tattva. Although for Upasana, it is mentioned that you meditate upon him in the right eye, Dakshinyakshini, or in the Hridakasha. So whatever is the Upasana, as per that, there is a Desha, there is a limited space, limited Desha where you can have the Bhavana, you can hold that Paramatma there for dhyana, for upasana, and that will have a particular phala. Similarly, this atma being stated as anu in the Hridayakasha does not make the atma anu, jivatma. So prajnyavat tadvyapadesha, this teaching of anutva and hridesha where this atma is, that teaching is similar to the teaching of Paramatma in the Upasana Kanda as being in the Dakshinyakshini or in the right eye or in the Hriddesha, in the heart. And this two is to refute the Purvapaksha. It is contrasting that now Purvapaksha Sutras are over and they are being refuted. So two means it is not so. However, on the other hand, that kind of a, so you can see such a thing. So two is Purvapakshi Vyavrutyartha. And tadguna saratvattu, meaning all these gunas which have you are claiming to be the gunas of atma, they are not really gunas of atma, says the Purvapaksha Siddhanti as response to Prathagopadesha, etc. Tadguna, see, tadguna saratva, the sara, the essence of what? Guna. So guna nam saraha, guna saraha, and kesham guna nam saraha. So the of the buddhi, what, why? Because this jnana which has been mentioned, this jnana is prajna shariram samaruhya, has been the quotation, last quotation of the Purvapakshi. So he has said prajna means this jnana in karane vitpatti. So therefore jnana is karana and atma is karta. So prajna shariram samaruhya, getting this knowledge through the buddhi. And that jnana as a guna is all pervasive. So this buddhi is separated out as karana from the karta, jivatma. And therefore this gunadvara asya sharira vyapitvam gamyate, avagamyate, it can be understood. To that the response is what? All these gunas that you are talking about, jnana as a guna, this jnana is not the guna of atma at all. But tadguna saratvat, meaning the sara, the essence of the gunas of that buddhi, that is there. How it is there? Actually, these gunas are of the buddhi itself. Jnana meaning the knowledge, bhavya vyutpatti jnana is not the guna of the atma, jivatma. Jnana as the bhavya vyutpatti knowledge is the guna of the karana buddhi, jnana. So this jnana shabda can be seen in two ways. Jnana is guna of atma, said the purva pakshi. And what is he saying? This jnana is bhavya vitpatti, meaning the knowledge. Knowledge is the guna of atma. And through that knowledge, via the buddhi, one can achieve it. And what does the tarkika say? Tarkika says that with association, meaning antakkarana, which also plays the role of buddhi, with association, having association with atma, where the jnana guna is there, that jnana guna through association reflects in the antakkarana buddhi. So the antakkarana is a karana. Antakkarana is a karana is agreeable to Vedanti also. But the Vedanti disagrees that jnana is the atma guna. What does he say? We say that atma does not have this guna. Why? Because atma is nirguna. It cannot have jnana as guna. Jnana is its very sarupa, but as chaitanya. This jnana which is there in the antakkarana, that is vrityatmaka jnana. It is agantuka, it comes and goes. And the vishaya which reflects in the vritti there, chaitanya lights up that vishaya in the vritti, and then you get jnana. And since there is a tadatmya sambandha with this antakkarana buddhi, playing the role of buddhi, where there is vritti, one has this knowledge as aham ghatam aham janami ityadi. How do you know I know the ghata? This ghata jnana takes place in the buddhi itself, vritti, but through the tadatmya sambandha, which is what bheda sahishnu advaita, abheda, bheda sahishnu abheda. So the bheda which is there, although there is really advaita, this bheda which is tolerated there, because all this is mithya. The ghata vritti taking place in the antakkarana, by association, chaitanya atma lights it up, and then there is a confusion as this ghata, I know that. That I is the ahankara really, which is also the role of the antakkarana. So having lit up the aham vritti and the idam vritti is ghata, eshaha ghata, that esha ghata vritti is separate from the aham vritti. Both are lit up by the same atma, and this pratibimbita jiva in the antakkarana, having association with the ahankara vritti, idam vritti, aham vritti, which is ahankara, there one has confusion, and when that's deluded as to I am this entity who is having this antakkarana, therefore the vritti is confused to be as oneself. Which vritti? Ahankara vritti, aham vritti. So one thinks oneself as a limited, and then there is reflection in the ghata vritti also, therefore he claims I know this ghata. Ghata, ghata, ghatam aham janami. So that is the process of knowledge in Vedanta. Now what the Purvapakshi has said, the guna of atma is jnana and buddhi gets it by association, it is exactly the other way around in the Vedanta Tattva. So Vedanta Darshana says that the jnana is the guna of buddhi. That buddhi also can be called as jnana. But what is that? Karne vitpatti. And what is the jnana which is the guna of that buddhi? That is bhavya vitpatti, meaning pure knowledge. That knowledge is the guna of the means of knowledge, buddhi. So the vritti is taking place. It has not the guna of atma, but by tadatmya sambandha, due to avidya, one misconstrues this jnana as taking place within oneself, and one says that I know this ghata. So tadguna sarattvattu, one is associated there because of the atma having the essence of this through vritti, tadatmya sambandha, one gets the essence of those gunas. It is not that the atma has this guna, jnana guna. Chaitanya is the meaning of that jnana, which is the swarupa. That chaitanya is not agantuka vrityatmaka jnana. So this is the basic meaning of the sutra, a little complicated there as to tadguna sarattvat. Then the vritti says on that, tuhu purva pakshi purva paksha vyavartakaha. So this purva paksha which has been given as to atma being anu and atma getting the knowledge or anubhava of anything that is happening in the entire sharira through this jnana, which is atma's guna. That is refuted by this tu here sitting here, this tu. So tuhu purva paksha vyavartaka, it's a refuter, literally it will vyavartaka mean refuter, it is that which is a negator of the purva paksha as presented in these past 10 sutras, etc. I think 10 sutras. Na eva anuhu jivaha, jiva is not anu at all. That is the vyavartana. What is the vyavrutti there? What is the refutation? Refutation is of that claim that jiva is anu. So Siddhanti says jivaha anuhu na nasti. Why? Sarvagatasya eva brahmana jiva bhavina pravesha shravanat tadatmi upadeshachya. Siddhanti says that the same Brahma who is discussed to be in Hridayakasha is Jiva. So when you say Jiva is in Hridayakasha, we have already said that Parabrahma by being in the Hridayakasha cannot be limited. It is for Upasana. So this Jiva is not different. So when Shruti says that Jiva with another Sanya as Jiva, who is limited because he has erroneous association with the Sharira, therefore he finds himself as limited, but by Swarupa he is not different from Brahma. So although we have already explained that this kind of a mantra which talks about Jiva being in Hridayakasha or Anu, all this is similar to Parabrahma being mentioned for in Upasana Kanda as being seen as limited in the Hridayakasha or other such areas which are given for Upasana. So just that statement will not be literal as to Jiva being Anu, just like Paramatma is not Anu. And what is the Pramana for this? Because we have the Pravesha Shruti. Anena Jivena Atmana Anupravishya. Who is doing Anupravesha? Anupravesha Shruti or Pravesha Shruti is this Parabrahma, Paramatma himself has entered the Sharira, and having entered the Sharira, what? He has become Jiva. Anena Jivena Atmana. So there is no real entering and becoming. It is all mentioned in a way that one understands this Jiva Bhava is of that for that Paramatma alone, not for anyone else. So where is this real, why is this entering discussed? The entering is manifestation itself. As and when the Akasha Tattva was manifested, we have seen that in the Srishti Prakriya, Parabrahma himself takes the Rupa as though of each and every Mahabhuta, and thereby Bhautikas also, and thereby when you get Annat Purushaha, there you have the Pancha Mahabhutas, then Bhautikas, Anna, and this Anna is partaken by the, is eaten by the people, Manushya, or any other, you know, and thereby in the Bija Rupa, Paramatma himself has pervaded across all of these Bhuta Bhautikas and the Sharira also. Then when the Sharira is born, through the Anna, the Paramatma has entered the Sharira already. So there is no separate entry, but the separate entry is discussed because Jiva finds himself as separate from this Bhuta Bhautika as an individual entity. And then has Tadatma Sambandha also. Paramatma is pervading entire Sharira in the form of Sharira itself, because Sharira is Bhautika, it is an elemental product of all the elements, born out of Anna, the Annamaya Kosha. So there itself Paramatma has already pervaded. But Chaitanya is not there. Where is the Chaitanya? Then in the Sukshma Sharira, which is also Bhautika, elemental products of the elements, there also Bhagavan is already there. But then the reflection causes a sort of enlivening this entity, a separate entity. That separate entity claims identity and ego, saying that I am an individual. Not in as many words, but through bhavana, through the feeling, this entity is now separate. He says that, oh no, I am not Paramatma. it needs to be taught that you are the Paramatma who has entered all these elements and then has entered the elementals also, Sukshma Sharira also, Sthula Sharira also. So all this is really you. And not only in this Sharira, across all Shariras, you are the one who is pervading everything as Paramatma, but you claim Jiva Bhava and individuality, and thereby you become segmented and then try to become Purna, which is not possible. If you are really limited, you cannot become limitless, you can never become Purna. So only through Jnana it is possible. This is the process. So this Tadguna Saratvattu, that Tadguna Saratvat is the Tadatmya Sambandha. The Upadesha is of Tadatmya because you already have it. The teaching is not telling you that you have Tadatmya Sambandha and then you have it, but it is revealing that you already have Tadatmya Sambandha. Unfortunately, the Tadatmya Sambandha visage is an individual Sarira. Otherwise, there is no issue with the Tadatmya Sambandha really. Why? Because Paramatma is identified with the entire and all the Shariras as Virat Purusha, as Hiranyagarbha. He does not have this problem. Who has the problem? Problem is when he finds himself as segmented as though with Jiva and identified with only a certain Sharira, with a certain gender, with a certain varna, with a certain ashrama, with a certain kamakrodhadi emotions, certain set of emotions. So this is the entity who is baddha. Shouldn't have been, but that is how the case is. Therefore, Shruti is just paraphrasing what you already have. The claim that you have not made in words, Shruti just makes it verbose, as to there is a tadatmya already there and it gives an upadesha through pravesha shravana. So pravesha shravanat, as what jiva bhavina, kasya jiva bhava asti, brahmana paramatmana eva. So sarvagatasya brahmana, so sarvagata brahma has taken jiva bhava. Just because he has taken jiva bhava does not make jiva bhava real. So how can the sarvagata, which is the reality of brahma and therefore of jiva, how can that jiva become anu? It is like saying that Parabrahma is Anu, because Parabrahma is one who is Jiva. He has entered in with the Jiva Bhava. Okay, Jiva is limited in that sense as to with identification with the Sharira. But truly his Sarupa is not limited. Therefore, Anu is a teaching as to what this Jivaha Anuhu. What we have seen as quoted by the Puropakshi, as to what this anutva shrutehe kagatihi, that kind of a question he has raised. If because in the end, what has he said? He has said there is definitely this jivahatu anuhu, and thereby anutva shrutya kasya virodha sarvagatatva shrutehe virodha. So he has said that anutva shruti is there, but then Siddhant is saying this anutva shruti is not the swarupa of atma, is not revealing the swarupa. It is showing that through Tadatmya Sambandha there is Anutva, because Tadatmya Sambandha is with the Sharira which is limited. Therefore, Sarvagatattva Shruti, which is the Swarupa of Atma, Parabrahma, as Parabrahma, there is no Virodha there at all. So that is the explanation given. So, Na Eva Anuhu Jiva, why Sarvagatasya Brahmana Jiva Bhavina Pravesha Shravanat and Tadatmya Upadeshacha, because then how is this Pravesha making this Jiva limited and thereby the Anushruti? Anushruti is because of Tadatmya Sambandha, not by Swarupa. Katham Tarhi Jive Anutva Yapadesha. It is because of this Tadatmya. What has happened? Those gunas, see, Tadatmya is identification as oneself. So whatever are the gunas, there will be Adhyasa. We have seen this Anyonya Adhyasa in the Adhyasa Vashya. So Anyonya Adhyasa is there. Jiva takes the jadadi qualities of the Sharira, and Sharira appears to be sentient by picking up the Chaitanya adi, Satta ityadi qualities of gunas of dharmas of Parabrahma Atma, Jivatma. So tadguna saratvat, tasyaha buddhehe gunaha. So tadguna sarat, buddhi gunas which are there, which are this jnana, in this case particularly jnana, which jnana? Agantuka jnana, vrityatmaka jnana. Not Chaitanya. Chaitanya Jnana is vice versa. It is superimposed Adhyastha in the Buddhi, Sukshma Sharira, from the स्वरूप चैतन्य ऑफ आत्मा बट दी आगंतुक ज्ञान मीनिंग वृत्यात्मक ज्ञान दैट इज सुपर इंपोज्ड फ्रॉम दी बुद्धि अंतकरण सूक्ष्म शरीर ऑन टू दी जीवात्मा सो तस्याः बुद्धे दिस तद्गुण मीन्स तस्याः गुणाः कस्याः तस्याः बुद्धे दि गुणाज ऑफ दोज बुद्धि विच आर वॉट एक्चुअली ऑल दीज विल ब्रिंग इन अणुत्व इत्यादि सो अणुत्वोत्क्रांति गति आगति सुख दुखादय सो दीज ज्ञानाज ऑफ वॉट सुख दुख इत्यादि आदि सो इत शैत्य विल ऑल्सो बी देर शैत्य इज ऑल्सो दि अनुभव विच टेक्स प्लेस दैट विल ऑल्सो बी देर इन दि बुद्धि इट्सेल्फ सो सुख दुख ऑल दीज आर टेकिंग प्लेस इन दि अंतकरण बुद्धि अणुत्व उत्क्रांति गति आगति वॉट आर दीज ऑल ऑफ दीज आर कवर्ड अक्रॉस मल्टीपल सूत्रास बाय द पूर्व पक्षी ही हैज सेड दैट दिस गति एंड आगति ऑफ द जीवा इज नॉट पॉसिबल अनलेस द जीवा इज लिमिटेड अदरवाइज हाउ कैन द सर्वगत सर्वव्यापी सर्वव्यापक तत्व लाइक परब्रह्म इफ जीवा इज लाइक दैट देन वाई डज इट नीड टू ट्रेवल टू अदर लोक सो दिस ट्रेवल टू लोक एंड कमिंग बैक फ्रॉम अदर लोक गति एंड आगति देन सुख दुख इत्यादि दीज आर लिमिटेड those limited gunas are all what and then utkranti leaving the body on death how can sarvagata sarvavyapaka atma leave the sharira at all because he is already there in all lokas he is there everywhere he the atma will have been pervading across the shariras also so why does there have to be utkranti from the sharira there won't be leaving the body anymore because this leaving is possible only if it is limited if it is limitless then there is no leaving the body because how it will leave it is there everywhere so that was the akshepa whereby anutva was claimed so anutva and utkranti gati agati sukha and dukha and adipadena all these emotions can be included all those are what te gunaha they te gunaha saram yasya pradhanam yasya they become primary and prime why pradhana sara is essence really but why pradhana is said there as a meaning for sara because they take you away from the reality they take the jiva away from the swarupa as parabrahma and tie that jiva to the limited buddhi through identification with the guna so the gunas are also identified with and the guni is also identified with And thereby what happens? There is a adhyasa both ways and then there is delusion as to which guna is whose. There is all mix-up. In Hindi what they say is bhel. So there is a complete bhel mix-up. You don't know what all is there. By taste you can identify something but the taste is also mixed up. When you eat something you say okay this is there, that is there, all that is mixed up. And mixing up can bring a separate taste also unless you have a very refined taste, you know, sense organ of taste. You say it tastes like this, but then it is a mix of two tastes. Mostly we can identify, but some tastes we cannot make out what it is. It feels like this, but that person has not added that ingredient. So similarly here, you don't know which dharma belongs to which dharma. This is the case of all samsaris, samsari jivas. So pradhanam yasya jivasya. Saha tatha means sa jivaha, jivatma. Tatha means what? Tatha means this tadguna saraha. Then tasya bhava tattvam. Tattvam is what? Tasya bhava tadguna saratsya bhavaha tadguna saratvam. That is tattvam. Then tasmat is panchami tadguna saratvat. Tasmat tadguna saratvat. So he has landed on the sutra word. In the vritti, Bhagavan Sadashiv Brahmendra has landed on that word. That he says that then further tadvyapadesha. What is tadvyapadesha? Teaching of that. अणुत्वादि व्यपदेश सो अणुत्व उत्क्रांति गति आगति सुख दुखादय दैट यू सी ऑल दैट टीचिंग इज बेस्ड ऑन दिस तादात्म्य संबंध वेयर वाय वन एंड्स अप बोरोइंग द गुणास एंड सुपर इम्पोजिंग ऑन वन सेल्फ न स्वाभाविक स्वाभाविक मीन्स इट्स नॉट नेचुरल इट इज नॉट स्वरूप ऑफ जीवात्मा प्राज्ञवत सो प्राज्ञवत शुड हैव बीन अंडरलाइन देयर प्राज्ञवत लाइक प्राज्ञ हु इज प्राज्ञ यथा प्राज्ञस्य प्राज्ञ इज परमात्मा प्राज्ञस्य परमात्मनः सगुणोपासनेषु दहराद्युपाधिवशात् अणुत्वादिकं व्यपदिश्यते तथा तद्वद् इत्यर्थः सो लाइक प्राज्ञ इज टॉट इन द उपासना कांड एज टू दहरादि उपासना वी हैव सीन दहराकाश देयर वन हैज टू सी वन सेल्फ हैज टू सी परमात्मा सॉरी परब्रह्म as being there. So you have darshana there, you imagine Paramatma, you do kalpana as Paramatma is there in Dhar Akasha, Hriday Akasha. So Saguna Upasana. And how this Paramatma has to imagine some swarupa of that, swarupa of the swarupa in a sense, the swarupa of Upasana. What is the, how is the Upasana? In the Upasana, this particular Devata should be seen in this manner. Some dhyana, etc., dhyana shloka. For example, in Vishnu Sahasranama, you have some dhyana. In Lalita Sahasranama, you have some dhyana. Parameshwari should be seen in this manner. So that is the dhyana you have to do. Gayatri Upasana, some dhyana. Similarly, in the Dhara Akasha, you see Paramatma in this manner. So some gunas are mentioned. So Saguna Upasana is there. Saguna Upasaneshu, Dhara Adi, Upadi Vashat. So Dhara becomes Upadi, and you say that in Dhara you have to imagine this Paramatma. So the Paramatma is now in this limited space, and thereby you think that Paramatma is limited. For a certain phala, you have to use certain gunas. Saguna, but then does not change the nirgunatva of Parabrahma and does not make the Vyapaka Paramatma Parabrahma as Anu. So Anutvadikam Vyapadishyate. It is all taught. In a limited space you have to imagine, so that limitedness of Paramatma is only for Dhyana. It is not Swabhavika, it is not Swarupataha Tadvadityartha. Similar is the case with this Jivatma discussion, where Anutvadi Gunas are Vyapadishyate, tad gunas are Vyapadishyate, meaning tad Vyapadesha is the teaching of tat. And what is tat? Tat is anutvadi gunas. Nanu atmani anutvadi samsarasya buddhyupadikatve kadachit buddhya viyoge samsaranasyat ityatah. Purvapakshi says, what kind of an explanation is this? If this is really true, then what would happen? Imagine this buddhi tadatmya sambandha is lost due to whatever, in whether you are sleepy or you have gone to sleep, then what will happen? This buddhi sanyoga going, meaning association with the buddhi, will take away tadatmya sambandha. Then the samsara itself will not be there. Why? Because samsara is known only through buddhi. If you do not know the samsara through the buddhi, then you are free. Samsara eva nasyat. When Vyoge sati, buddhya vyoge sati, buddhya saha, saha tritiya, buddhya saha ya sambandha, tadatme sambandha, that is vyoga, that is yoga. Vyoga is viruddha, viruddha to that means there is a disassociation. So when the association tadatme sambandha with the buddhi goes away, in fact it is ishtapatti. Why? This tadatme sambandha will go only by jnana, by atma jnana, by aikya jnana. This is the siddhanta. But Purvapakshi is saying that somehow this Vyoga goes away. That somehow is not by Jnana. So he does not mean by Brahma Jnana. It is somehow. What is that somehow? So we can see in other ways. We can imagine ways in which, you know, a person is in a coma. Or, you know, some disease whereby he has somehow dissociated with this. You know, there are many who have a schizophrenic, and then they take a second personality. So this fellow is someone who, due to what, amnesia or anything, loss of memory or whatever it is, that he loses his sambandha with the buddhi. Then what will happen? There will be no samsara. This is the akshepa by the Purvapakshi. Nanu atmani anutvadi samsarasya. This anutvadi is basically what it is all, anutvadi and then samsara. You can see it separately also, because anutva itself is not samsara, but sukadukha ityadi can be seen as samsara also, or samsara is causing this sukadukha, or sukadukha is causing samsara. Always you can interpret such kind of samasas. So anutvadi samsarasya, this samsara which includes anutvadi gunas. Meaning what? Anutva, Utkranti, Gati, Agati, Sukadukha. So Gati, Agati is definitely samsara. Samsara is what? Samsaranam. Cyclical birth and death. So Gati is death. Agati is birth. So birth and death is samsara. So Anutvadi samsara which is there, which leads to Sukadukha, or Sukadukha Anubhava will further lead to samsara. It is all cyclical. So that samsara, samsarasya, buddhi upadi katve, if that samsara is due to buddhi as upadi, so who has the samsara, samsarana? संसार और संसरण इज देयर फॉर आत्मा. सो आत्मा इज संसारी, जीवात्मा इज संसारी. दैट संसारी जीवात्मा हैज बिकम संसारी जीवात्मा बाय दिस संसार विच इज अणुत्वादी इन दी बुद्धि सुपर इम्पोजिंग ऑल दैट ऑन हिमसेल्फ. सो बुद्धि उपाधिकत्व, व्हेन बुद्धि बिकम्स एन उपाधि बाय एसोसिएशन एंड तादात्म्य संबंध, ऑल दीज गुणाज आर सुपर इम्पोज ऑन वन सेल्फ. एंड देन वन थिंग दैट संसार इज नॉट इन देर इन बुद्धि सुख दुखादि, ऑल दीज आर इन मी, देर फोर संसार अस्य मम अस्ति इति अहम संसारी. का संसारी? अहमेव संसारी. दिस इज द मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग. सो इफ दैट इज द केस, पूर्वपक्षी सिंह, इफ इट इज सो एज टू संसारित्व इज प्राप्त बाय उपाधि संबंध, एंड वॉट इज दट उपाधि? बुद्धि. सो बुद्धि संबंध, बुद्धि बीइंग द उपाधि, देन कदाचित बुद्धि उपाधिकत्वे सति. वेन सच इज द केस और सच इज युअर आर्ग्यूमेंट, देन युअर द सिद्धांत इज आर्ग्यूमेंट, देन कदाचित वॉट विल हैपन समहाउ एट सम टाइम, कदाचित, कदाचित काले, कदा काले दा, सो इन सम काल बुद्ध्या वियोगे सति. देन इफ एट ऑल सम टाइम देर इज डिसोसिएशन फ्रॉम दिस बुद्धि, देन संसार न स्या, देर वोंट बी संसार. सो मोक्ष प्रसंग, विच इज वॉट? अकस्मात, अकस्मात देर विल बी मोक्ष, वेदर आर यू वॉन्ट इट, यू डोंट हैव टू बी साधक एटसेट्रा. सो दिस ऑल बी अनिष्ट. इफ अकस्मात वन इज गोइंग टू गेट संसार टू गो, देन ऑल दिस साधना इज फ्यूटाइल, शास्त्र इज फ्यूटाइल. दैट इज ऑल्सो कोरोलरी टू दिस. बट सिद्धांति विल से इष्टापत्ति, बिकॉज दिस देर विल बी नो अकस्मात वियोग. वियोग इज पॉसिबल ओनली बाय परब्रह्म ज्ञान, बाय महावाक्य ज्ञान, बाय श्रवण मनन निधिध्यासन. इट इज नॉट अ जोक. बट एनी वे, पूर्वपक्षीज माइंड इज नॉट वॉट द सिद्धांति रीड्स एज. सो इस इज अकस्मात वियोगे सति, कदाचित इज अकस्मात, सम हाउ सम टाइम, वी डोंट नो हाउ, वी डोंट केयर हाउ. डू यू एग्री? सो टू दैट इत्यतः टू दैट भगवान सूत्रकार व्यासाचार्य सेज, यावद आत्मभावित्वाच्च न दोषस्तद्दर्शनात्, यावद आत्मभावित्वाच्च न दोषस्तद्दर्शनात्. सो यावद आत्मभावित्वात्, वन वर्ड, च न दोषः, वाय? तद्दर्शनात्. यू हैव सीन सो इन द श्रुति, देयर इज ओनली वन वे टू गेट दिस वियोग, थ्रू श्रवण मन निधिध्यासन, थ्रू ब्रह्म ज्ञान. सो न दोष, दैट इज नॉट अ दोष एट ऑल. इष्टापत्ति इफ यू से वियोग, इफ इट हैज, बट कदाचित कम इज नॉट पॉसिबल. दिस कदाचित कम दैट यू से, दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. समहाउ इट विल नॉट हैपन, इट विल हैपन द वे श्रुति हैज शोन, ओनली थ्रू ज्ञान, ब्रह्म ज्ञान, महावाक्य, श्रवण मन निधिध्यासन अलोन दिस ज्ञान विल टेक प्लेस, एंड डेफिनेटली वियोग विल टेक प्लेस. एंड विद दैट डेफिनेट वियोग, there will be definite factual samsarana syat kind of a scenario. Samsarana syat jnaninah, that is a fact, tad darshana. But in your case, what is your aropa? Kadachit kyam, meaning kadachit, kadachit viyoge sati buddhyasaha. There the siddhanti is saying yavad atma bhavitvat, as long as Atma Bhava is there, there is no way you can get away from. Atma Bhava is that limited Jivatma Bhava. As long as this Atma Bhava does not go away, Jivatma Bhava, limited Bhava, the Buddhi association will be there. And how will that go away? Only by Brahma Bhava. So as long as Brahma Bhava is not there, then Atma Bhava is there. This Atma Bhava is not Brahma Bhava, Brahmatma Bhava, it is Jivatma Bhava, limited Jivatma Bhava. So Yavad Atma Bhavitvat, due to that Bhavi, one having Atma Bhava is Atma Bhavi. So Yavad Atma Bhavitvam, Yavad is a separate word. I said Yavad Atma Bhavitvat, single word, Yavat is a separate word, Atma Bhavitvat. Because Yavat is, Yavat Tavat are relative and correlative, they are separate. I meant the Atma Bhavitvat is a single word. Perhaps I said Yavad Atma Bhavitvat. Yavat, Yavat, and then Atma Bhavitvat is a single word. So Atma Bhavitvam is the guna for the Atma Bhavi. And who is Atma Bhavi? One who has Atma Bhava. And what is Atmabhava? Atmabhava can be, if you see at Brahma Bhava, then as long as Brahma Bhava is not attained. And if you read a Jiva Bhava, that is also possible. You can say Jiva Bhava. Then Jiva Bhava, as long as Jiva Bhava is there. Because Yavat means as long, so long. So what should you say? Let me just see how Bhagavan Bhashyakara, both ways the explanation can be there, but you have to read as long as what? As long as Atma Bhava is there, if you say, then it will mean as long as Jiva Bhava is there. In limited sense of Jiva, individual Jiva Bhava is there. But then if you say Brahma Bhava as Atma, then Yavad Brahma Bhava if you say, then as long as Brahma Bhava is not attained, so long. Just give me a moment, I'll just clarify this. Because both ways are possible, I like both ways, but then let's stick to Bhashya. Yeah, so I think it is given limited. So Bhagavan Bhashya, Bhashyakara gives a limited this thing. So Jiva Bhava. So we'll stick with Jiva Bhava, although Brahma Bhava can be explained, but as long as Jiva Bhava is there. Because there is a na to be read additionally there, yavat, as long. So as long as Atma Bhava is there in oneself, meaning what? As long as Jiva, limited Jiva Bhava is there in oneself, meaning as long as Tadatmya Sambandha, created Jiva Bhava is there, thereby this Anutvait Prapta by Avidya, therefore due to Avidya, so yavat Atma Bhavitvat, that becomes Hetu. As long as this Atma Bhava is there, so long what will happen? There will be samsara, therefore na doshaha. What is the dosha not there? The samsara na syat, that kind of a dosha is not accrued. Is not applicable in our paksha at all. Why? Because our paksha is Shruti paksha, tad darshanat. Tad darshanat. Because tad darshanat can be taken as a Shruti also. It can be taken as in loka also. In anubhava it is there. Just because you go to sleep and disassociate from the buddhi, the association with the buddhi, meaning viyoga of the buddhi does not take place because it is there, the sanyoga with the buddhi is there in bija avastha. So even if you go to sleep, this buddhi sanyoga will be there. Although there is viyoga in the manifest state, there is in the unmanifest bija avastha, there is sanyoga. Therefore you wake up with sanyoga with the buddhi and claim that I am this person, father of these many children, son of this person, or whatever it is. So all that sanyoga is there in the buddhi, in the bija avastha. Therefore tad-darshanat also possible, and tad-darshanat shruti says so. Vritti says, buddhi sanyogasya yavat atmanaha samyak darshanena samsaro na nivartate tavat bhavitvat na ukta doshaha. So as long as one has no nivritti of samsara from due to samyak darshana, what will happen? Tavat bhavitvat. So actually in bhashya it is in one way, in vritti it is seen in another way also. Or bhashya may have both ways also. I have not seen the entire bhashya before patha. So buddhi sanyogasya yavat atmana samyak darshana na nivartate. So as long as buddhi sanyoga buddhi sanyogasya atmanaha samyak darshanena samsaraha na nivartate tavad bhavitvat. So this tavad bhavitvat will go with buddhi sanyogasya tavad bhavitvat, because this buddhi sanyoga will be there in oneself. And therefore this tadatmya sambandha will create all these gunas to be appearing in oneself, and therefore one will think oneself as samsari. So that is tad bhavitvam. What is that tad bhavitvam? This atma bhavitvam. This atma bhavitvam is buddhi sanyogasya atma bhavitvam. Tavad bhavitvam. So he says tavad means so long. So long what? As long. As long as what? As long as samsara nivarana does not take place. So what you are claiming, the Purvapakshi, is other way round. What is the Purvapakshi saying? Akasmat kadachit buddhya viyoge samsara nasyat. But Siddhanti is saying, as long as samsara does not go away. And how will samsara go away? By jnana. So long this buddhi sanyoga will be there. So the argument of the Purvapakshi is turned around on him. Siddhanti says, you are reading it exactly opposite to what the fact is. You are saying that if the buddhi sanyoga goes away, samsara will go away, akasmat. But the fact is that this akasmat thing will not work. It will be due to a hetu. What is the hetu? Jnana, brahma jnana. So as long as brahma jnana does not take place, samsara will not go away. And as long as samsara does not go away, so long this buddhi sanyoga will be there. In fact, that ajnana being there, there is buddhi sanyoga. That ajnana has to be treated. It is not that buddhi sanyoga has to be taken away without ajnana being taken away. That will never happen. So, atmanaha samyak darshane samsaraha yavanna nivartate. That's how you can read it. Atmanaha samyak darshane atmanaha atma atmanaha samsarana nivartate. Samsara for the atma does not go away. How long? As long. As long as it takes, we don't know how long it will take. Samyak darshana has to take place. So whatever you do for samyak darshana, that alone will take away samsara for atma. So samsara for atma yavanna nivartate, as long as it does not go away. Due to what will it go away? Samyak darshanena. So samyak darshanena samsaraha nivartate, but yavanna nivartate for atma, atmanaha. So long what? Buddhi sanyogasya tavada. So long buddhi sanyogasya bhavitvam na nivartate. Bhavitvam bhavati eva. Buddhi sanyoga will continue to be, and then one will say atma bhavitvam, jiva bhava will be there. Atmanaha bhav. So you can say buddhi sanyoga, since buddhi sanyogasya samyak darshana samsarani nivartate. So it's a very tricky statement. How to read? Because atma bhavitvam is there, but in the vakya it is difficult to read atma bhavitvam. Atmanaha tavad bhavitvam. What is that tavad? Buddhi sanyogasya bhavitvam. Atma will see buddhi sanyogasya atmana. That's another way to read. Atma is what kind of an atma? Who has sanyoga with the buddhi? So buddhi sanyogasya atmanaha tavad bhavitvam bhavati eva. So atma will continue to have buddhi sanyoga. So that is the bhava. What is that atma bhava? Buddhi sanyoga atma bhava. Meaning the limitedness brought in by the buddhi sanyoga. That kind of limited bhava will continue to be there. I hope it is clear now, because it's a very tricky sentence to make an anvaya and understand. Multiple ways it can be read, but then finally we'll stick to what? Buddhi sanyogasya atmanaha bhavitvam. What is that? Atma bhava is buddhi sanyoga atma bhava, meaning limited atma bhava. And thereby we can read the way I cross checked with the Mula Sutra in the Bhashya, meaning the way Bhashya sees it. So vritti is a paraphrasing of that, a particular part there. So therefore what? Na ukta dosha. What is ukta dosha? Samsaraha akasmat will go away. That is not possible. Kadachit. Tatkasmat, and why do you say so? If the Purva Pakshi were to ask, Tadarshanat, says the Sutrakara. Deha Vyogi api tasya buddhi sanyogasya darshanat, loke. So Deha Vyogi, even when Deha Vyoga is there, you can read it loke also. Why so? Because in sleep you think that there is no buddhi sanyoga. If it is there, you will not be able to sleep at all. In deep sleep, there is no buddhi sanyoga. Therefore, there is no sapna possible. There is no vyavahara in the jagrat avastha, kind of a vyavahara. That kind of vyavahara is not possible in sushupti. And vyavahara seen in swapna is also not possible. Why? Because buddhi sanyoga is not there. So one can take it that way also, as to deha vyogi api sushuptau tasya buddhi sanyogasya darshanat. So that can be one reading. But tad darshana is basically darshana shabda. Utsarga is what? Generally that means shruti. So there is no loka word there. Loke darshanat, but we can read it that way also as an example. But moola meaning is what? Shruti, which I explained in the moola also. In shruti we see that sa samana sannubhav loka anusarachrati ityadi shrutav darshanat ityartha. It is seen in the shruti, and you have anubhava also. You can't say that I don't understand what the shruti is saying, because shruti says what? Sa samanaha buddhya sah samanasan tadatmya sambandha is shown. Buddhi sanyogasya darshanat, where in the shruti, where is this buddhi sanyoga mentioned in this mantra? Samanaha. Samana is buddhi samanaha. He is similar to the buddhi, and buddhi there means basically vijnanamaya kosha, really. सो बुद्धि इज एक्चुअली अ कोश विच इज अंतकरण ऑल राइट बट अंतकरण प्लेज द रोल ऑफ मना एज वेल एज बुद्धि देयर फॉर दिस मना प्राणमय कोश इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम मनोमय कोश विच इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम विज्ञानमय कोश ऑल दीज आर सूक्ष्म शरीर प्राण कैन हैव बी स्थूल ऑल्सो देर इज एन ओवरलैप बट देन मनोमय कोश एंड विज्ञानमय कोश आर शुद्ध सूक्ष्म शरीर अंतकरण बट देन देर इज अ तादात्म्य संबंध देर फॉर ओवर दैट मनोमय इज टेकन एज आत्मा देन वंस यू डू कॉग्निटिव एनालिसिस एंड से दैट ओके श्रुति इज सेइंग इट इज अ कोश नॉट आत्मा देन अन्योंतरात्मा विज्ञानमय सो विज्ञानमय विल बिकम आत्मा प्राणमय लाइक प्राणमय मनोमय विल ऑल्सो बिकम कोश नॉट आत्मा सो दिस अहंकार स्वरूप विज्ञानमय कोश दैट इज टेकन टू बी वन सेल सो बुद्धि मीन्स विज्ञानमय ऑल्सो सो यू कैन सी दैट बुद्धि संयोगस्य स समानः बुद्धि समान दिस आत्मा जीवात्मा इज बुद्धि समान परमात्मा बिकम्स बुद्धि समान एंड बीइंग सो स समान सन बुद्धि समान सन विज्ञानमय कोश बीइंग टेकन एज आत्मा सो समान सन तादात्म्य संबंध बीइंग देर उभौ लोकौ अनुसंचरति गोज अक्रॉस लोकास एंड टू लोकास कैन बी सीन दिस लोका एंड दैट लोका एज गति Then Agati has what? That loka and this loka. So goes to another loka and comes back to this loka when the phala is exhausted. Anusancharati. Following karma he keeps on going. But with association with what? With this sukshma sharira. That sukshma sharira sambandha is definitely there even after marana. Because otherwise gati is not possible. Purvapakshi has said that therefore this fellow has to be anu. No, he is not anu. Really by swabhava swarupa this is not swabhavika swabhavika anuttam is not there by swarupa he is still vibhu but this buddhi sanyoga is still there so you say that having left the body he still has to be anu to travel yes but having left the sthula sharira not sukshma sharira so sukshma sharira tadatmya sambandha is still there that sukshma sharira is traveling so this vibhu atma who has तादात्म्य संबंध विद दि अणु सूक्ष्म शरीर अणु इन द सेंस विथ अ लिमिटेड रादर विथ अ लिमिटेड सूक्ष्म शरीर विच ट्रेवल्स हैज गति एंड आगति हैविंग एसोसिएशन दिस विभु परमात्मा बाय जीवात्मा बाय स्वरूप विभु कंसिडर्स वन सेल्फ टू बी अणु सो दैट अणुत्व बाय तादात्म्य संबंध इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड earlier and that continues there why because having left the sthula sharira in marana sukshma sharira association is still there anyway the swapna idea will also come up which I have already covered so it will be easier next so saha samana san ubhau lokau anusancharati ityadi shrutau darshanad ityartha meaning the buddhi sambandha has not gone so there is no kadachit buddhya viyoga in marana also it is not there let alone in sushupti So there is no kadachitkem at all. There will definitely be no akasmat samsara nivrutti. It will be only through shravana. And if one feels that there is akasmat samsara nivrutti for someone, then shravana mana nididhyasana has been done in the earlier janma. There is no way that there will be kadachitka mukti. ननु सुषुप्तौ ब्रह्म संपत्ति कार्यनाशयोः अभ्युपगमात् न बुद्धि संयोगस्य यावद् आत्मभावित्वम् इत्यतः इनफैक्ट दिस यावद् आत्मभावित्वम् कैन ऑल्सो बी अ समास आई थिंक यावद् समास इज पॉसिबल सो इट कैन बी रेड इन दैट मैनर ऑल्सो बट यावद् इज यूजुअली सीन एज सेपरेट सो हियर ऑल्सो वेन पूर्वपक्षी सेज यावद् यावत् आत्मभावितम् व्हाट इज दिस यावत् बेसिकली यावत् इज इंक्लूडेड टू टेल यू दैट यू हैव टू ब्रिंग अ तावत् सो व्हेन यदा इज देयर यू हैव टू ड्रैग अ तदा इवन इफ इट इज नॉट देयर इन द श्लोक और मंत्र फॉर अन्वय वी ब्रिंग इन तदा जस्ट लाइक एडिंग बाय एक थिंग वाक्यम इफ तिंगंत पद इज नॉट देयर यू ऐड भवति अस्ति वर्तते विद्यते सच सच वर्ड्स आर टू बी ब्रॉट इन कर्तरी प्रयोग जनरली even if krudanta shabda is there, that krudanta shabda, unless it is a krityant, kritya pratyaya is there, you can read a asti vartate ityadi chinganta shabda. Similarly, what yada is there, tada is brought in. Relative correlatives go together. So yavad is there in the sutra, tavad has to be brought in for anvaya. That is done in the sutra. So yavad is there, tavad has to be brought in. So yavad bhavitva means what? As long as something is there, some kind of a state of tadatmya sambandha is there, so long there will be samsara. Or other way around, what has been in the vritti, it has been shown as the other way around to what the purvapakshi has understood. So as long as samsara is there, so long this identification is there. So purvapakshi is not really at fault by saying that as long as he is reading, as long as this sambandha is there, so long samsara will be there. That is what you have understood, Siddhanti. So he is not reading the Siddhanti wrong, but then Siddhanti is answering that it is other way around also. Meaning, jnana, when you look at the reverse engineering, the jnana alone can take away this samsara. So as long as jnana is not there, samsara is there. So I can see it other way around also. As long as samsara is there, there will be definite jiva bhava. You cannot say that, oh, he does not have jiva bhava, but samsara is there. That is the reason we read Mula Vidya. That is why we say that even jnani, from other's perspective, there is definite samsara. Meaning prarabdha is there. You cannot say prarabdha is not there, otherwise sharira wouldn't have been there. So therefore, some kind of samsarittvam should be understood. Meaning as long as prarabdha is there, so long samsarittvam, be it very, very limited. That has to be there because there is mula avidya, there is, ajnana, avidya, shesha is read. There is some kind of even at least an ausha, a drop of avidya has to be read in a jnani also who has sharira. He may not have this ahankara, he may not have jiva bhava, but from the perspective of the onlookers, this kind of an avidya is read for logic, nothing else. Logically, it cannot be said because people will not understand, oh, he has no samsara, he is brahma tattva, he is free, he has nothing to do with the sharira. But sharira is there. And if you don't read that, what will happen? Then how is the jnani teaching? The entire sampradaya will fall apart. Because if prarabdha is not there, how is the jnani teaching? How is jnani, and what is he teaching? How will it be valid? Unless, some kind of, samsarana is there. Samsarana is there, meaning that jiva bhava itself, without that, there cannot be guru and shishya bhava. Without guru and shishya bhava, advaita tattva, teaching won't work. Even the teaching of Advaita, teaching will need Dvaita. There cannot be any teaching in Advaita. In fact, in Bhagavan Karikakara, Gaudapadacharya says in the Mandukya Karika, that all this is for the purpose of teaching Upadesha Matra also Bhavatu. But then that Dvaita is accepted for that reason. So much you have to accept at least. Only that much, but at least that much you have to accept. Only that much, be it so. But it has to be accepted. Logically. So now the Sushupti example, that becomes the, what we discussed, that becomes the Purvapaksha. Nanu Sushuptau Brahma Sampatti Karyanashayo Abhyupagamat. Because you, the Vedanti Siddhanti, has also accepted. What have you accepted? Brahma Sampatti Karyanasha. All this which is Sampanna as Brahma Karya, Prapancha, Jagrat Prapancha, and Swapna Prapancha also. All that is with Brahma as Karana. Therefore, it is Brahma Sampatti Karya. And the nasha of those, sampatti, karya and nasha. So both have been accepted. Shushupto brahma sampatti karya nasha yoho abhyupagamat. There is no karya, meaning the karya of the brahma in swapna also and jagradavastha also. Both have been taken by the siddhanti. In jagradavastha and swapna it is there. In Sushupti, he said it is not there. Sushuptau nasti. This Brahma, their nasha. Nasha yoho abhyupa. So Brahma sampatti and karya nasha. Brahma sampatti and karya nasha both have been accepted in Sushupti. Therefore, what? Therefore, he says, therefore, na buddhi sanyogasya yavad atma bhavitvam ityata. Meaning in Sushupti that yavad atma bhava is not there. Meaning as long as that samsara is not there, so long jiva bhava will be there. Where is the jiva bhava in Sushupti? So that is the basic idea there. He says that in the rather just let me because nasheo dual just give me one moment. Let me just think some other way to understand this because why nashayoho dual? Let me first cross check whether nashayo is there in the printed book. Nashayoho, yeah, Brahma Sampati Karya Nashayo. I'm unable to make sense out of it as to why dual. Huh, okay, so Brahma Sampatti. So Brahma Sampatti can be understood as what? The Ekata with Brahma. So for a Jnani also it is possible. So this Brahma Sampatti being one with Brahma, which the Siddhanti is claiming, whether it be a Jnani or an Ajnani, this Brahma Sampatti is a fact. Aikya with Brahma is a fact. That is what Siddhanti is claiming. So you can look at it from that angle. The Purvapakshi is saying that, okay, you claim that, yeah? You claim Brahma Sampatti. And this Prapancha is what it is, Karya, Brahma Karya. So Jiva is actually, you are saying, by Swarupa, one with Brahma, therefore he is Vibhu. So that Vibhutva Nasha. So you can read as Vibhutva Nasha and Karya Nasha also. So this is how you can make a dual. I was thinking why, how this dual, because Sampatti I read in a different manner. So now you can read Sampatti as this, see Pat Dhatu, Sampurvaka. So you can say this Samyak Prapti kind of a meaning as to Swarupena. So by Swarupa, Jiva is Brahma is the claim of the Siddhanti, says the Purvapakshi. Is that there in Shushupti? In Shushupti, this Vibhutva cannot be claimed by Siddhanti also, says the Purvapakshi. Why? Although by Swarupa, Jiva is claimed to be Brahma, in Shushupti that Brahma Bhava is not there, is the claim by Purvapakshi. What the fact is, laid aside for a Jnani. But for an Ajnani or a Jnani, Swarupa of Jiva is Brahma. So Brahma Sampatti is there. And Prapancha, Jagrit Prapancha, Swapna Prapancha is all Brahma Karya. Whether Swapna Prapancha is Brahma Karya, Jiva Karya, Jiva is Abhinna from Brahma. So we'll just read the Purvapaksha as what? The Jiva being Brahma and Jiva's Brahma's Karya, Prapancha, whether it is Jagrita or Swapna Prapancha, both undergo Nasha and Shushupti Avastha. So this is how you can bring in a dual. So Brahma Sampatti. So the meaning of Brahma Sampatti was doubted, so it is seen as Ekarupata. So somewhere it is said Ekarupata. So Brahma Sampatti means Ekarupata of the Jiva. And thereby Vibhutva can be claimed by the Siddhanti, but it cannot be claimed in Sushupti. Then Karyanasha. Karyanasha is also there in Sharira, no Shariras, none, no Shariras survive in the Sushupti Avastha, whether it be Jagras Sharira or Swapna Sharira, and anybody's, not only the Swapna Drashtas, but all those who are seen in the Swapna or all those seen in the Jagrat Drashta also, in the Jagrat, none of the Shariras survive in the, so Prapancha inclusive, all of the Shariras will undergo Nasha in Sushupti Avastha. Therefore, Brahma Sampatti and Karya Nasha are accepted. And that becomes the Hetu. Brahma Sampatti Karya Nashayo Abhyupagamat, due to acceptance of these two. Na Buddhi Sanyogasya Yavadatma Bhavitvam. Then how will there be Buddhi Sanyoga in Sushupti Avastha? Ityataha Pumstvadivattasya Sato Abhivakti Yogat. Pumstvadivattasya Sato Abhivakti Yogat. So Pumstvadivat. The Vritti is short. I'll just finish it, although we have gone over the R. Pumstvadivat. Like Pumstvamitya. So Padachide Pumstvadivat Tasya Sataha Abhivyakti Yogat. So Abhivyakti is possible. Abhivyakti in Shushupti also it's possible. The Udharana is Pumstvadivat. So Pumstvam Sthritvam, being a man, being a woman, दीज आइडियाज आर देर ऑल दो द शरीरा इज अंडर गोइंग नाशा कंटिन्यूअसली. साइंस ऑल्सो सेज दैट. सो दिस शरीरा विच इज अंडर गोइंग कंटिन्यूअस नाशा और एटलीस्ट इन वॉट बालावस्था यौवनावस्था वृद्धावस्था यू कैन सी शरीरा इज कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट. यू कैनॉट इवन आइडेंटिफाई समबडी हु शोज यू हिज चाइल्डहुड फोटो इन ओल्ड एज. So in old age, you look at a young photo also. Oh, you know, my father was so dashing in his young age. Now look at him. It should be vairagya karaka for us. As to you thinking that this, to beautify this sharira, do alankara, makeup and get-ups, protect the sharira, build muscles, whatever it is. All this beauty will not last. Health will not last. That should be vairagya karaka. But still we have to take care of the body because it is a sadhana for antakkarana and for our own sadhana. So that much we have to take care of the sharira. Now this sharira that was there in the yavanavastha, is it same in the vruddhavastha? What was there in the balavastha, is it there same in the yavanavastha? It is not. For no one is it so. Even for, we can say for avatara purusha also it is not so. They also have to undergo sharirika suffering. Whether they suffer or not is a different story, but then sharira undergoes changes. Sharira has all these jara vyadi ityadi. So sharira is different, completely different. Otherwise it will not look different. Definitely it is a different sharira, but even with the different sharira, not with the modern gender confusion, the rainbow gender, does anyone get confused as to, you know, in childhood I was a, I was a boy, I had this, masculine and now the linga has changed. Linga is not going to change. So one knows that in childhood also one was a man, now a man in the sense, a boy, and now the same boy continues as a man. So these guna and adi shabdena, all these other things can also be taken. As to varna ityadi, sharira has a varna, so that varna is there, the varna is not going to change. So we are discounting these modern days ridiculous ideas of gender changing and all that. But then pumstvaadi vat, just like sharira being different in the person aging, the jiva is as though aging through different shariras, he has taken different shariras in the same janma. We can't see it, but it's a fact. Still, the Pumbhava, Stribhava does not go away. Adipadena, Varnabhava does not go away. I am a Kshatriya, Brahmana, Vaishya. Does not go away. I belong to this family, does not go away. Across different Shariras also, in the same Janma, then how will this, how do you say that in Shushupti it will go away? In Shushupti, it will not go, it will be there in the Bijavastha. That when I sleep as a man, I'll wake up as a man. Even the modern day, whatever gender that person thinks, he'll wake up in the same gender. In sleep, nothing is going to change unless it's a movie. I'm just recalling something funny incident. But then, this is what, the fact is. Whatever varna, whatever jnana, whatever gender one sleeps with, one wakes up as that. So how can you claim that suddenly in Sushupti all this gender, jnana, etc. goes away? Ajnani wakes up as an ajnani, jnani wakes up as a jnani. Man wakes up as a man, woman wakes up as a woman. Just like a male child grows up to be a young male, female child grows up to be a young female and grows up to be an old woman. The young man grows up to be an old man. Similarly is the case across a single day when one goes to sleep. So I'll finish the vritti. Yatha balye pumswadehe sataha eva abhivyakti yoga. Therefore such abhivyakti is there, meaning sorry, I got a throat thing. Just give me a moment. Sorry. So this abhivyakti asya is also there. Sorry, bumswadiva tasya or asya. Just give me one moment. I read the sutra wrong. Let me just cross check. Is there a typo? I think there is a Patha Veda perhaps. Does anyone have Pumstvadi Vat Tvasya? If it is Tvasya, then Tuvasya. If it is Tasya, then only Tasya. So both are possible. There may be a Patha Veda somewhere I read in. I didn't read the Sutra all that way, but then in some Padacheda there is a mention in some this thing. Somebody has translated it in that manner. I was just looking up. So there is a Tuvasya. So if it is Tuvasya, then it will become Tvasya. I think in book the print shows the sutra as Pumstvadiva Tasya. So we'll stick to what I read in the sutra. So Tasya. Tasya va bhavatu, tu asya va bhavatu, the same meaning. Whether there are additional tu and asya. Asya asya will also mean for this, and tasya will mean for that. So what is that? Pumstvadiva Tasya Sataha. Sataha meaning one who is sun, existent. Tasya sataha, asya sataha va, so tasya sataha, abhivyakti yoga, because of yoga, what yoga? Yoga of abhivyakti, abhivyakti is manifestation, so manifestation of these gunas will definitely be there, like the manifestation of pumvadi gunas, so all these gunas will still be there across this shushupti avastha also, they will survive the shushupti avastha, that is the meaning there. So yatha balye pumstvadehe sata eva yauvane abhivyaktihi tadvat tasya buddhi sanyogadi. So buddhi sanyogadehe sata, which are existing, they are not non-existent in sushupti. The manifestation of buddhi sanyoga ityadi when one wakes up is only because it survives in sushupti, otherwise it won't be there. Otherwise it will become agantuka. This kada chitkam that you are claiming, if that is a possibility, there is no vyavastha. Shastra will be futile. So shushuptau sukshmatmana sata eva abhivyakti sambhavat. This manifestation of gunas such as buddhi sanyoga, and then by extension what are those? The anutvadi, anutva, this the anutva, utkranti, gati, agati, that will be there in marana, etc. That all those gunas that are bhavi, meaning they may take place. But currently what? Sukadukha ityadi. But at least what Purvapakshi is claiming, Anutva, that Anutva Guna, a single Guna which is there in the Buddhi by Tadatmya Sambandha Prapta in Atma, that Guna should have continued in Shushupti Avastha. So Anumana is without that is not possible. Arthapatti Pramana also. But you see that in waking one has that Guna continuing, just like Kumbhava. Therefore what? Yatha balye pumstvadehe sata eva yauvane abhivyakti. This manifestation of being a male, being a female is there in the yauvana avastha, as in a young age, which was there in balya avastha also. That very pumstvadehi abhivyakti is there because it continues in across shariras. Tadvata tasya buddhi sanyogade, all these gunas, tasya, so in the vritti it is read as tasya. So I have not underlined these. So some I have forgotten, or some I have not visited at all. So tasya buddhi sanyogade shushuptau sukshmatmana sata eva, meaning not asata, sata eva. Those gunas are there in shushupti avastha also. How? Sukshmatmana, in the sukshma swarupa they are there. Atma means swarupa here. So sukshma swarupena shushuptau api gunanam satta asti. Buddhi sanyogadi gunanam satta asti. So the buddhi sanyogadi which is existent in the shushupti avastha also, that alone can have abhivyakti. Sata eva abhivyakti sambhavat. In waking up, on waking up, these gunas continue to be, just like kumbhava will also continue. Yavad atma bhavitvam na viruddhyate ityartha. Therefore this individuality, that I am this jivatma, having this anutvadi gunas, sukadukhadi, that will also continue. There is absolutely no virodha ityartha. Sorry, I thought that it is a small sutra, it will take a minute, but it took so much. Let's continue in the next part. Amne yante samsiddham adhimadhyanta varjitam anandaghanam apurnam atmajyoti rupasmahe. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Namaste, Pramji. Thank you.